Filled with an abundance of roses, chocolate, and love flying through the air, Valentine's Day is supposed to be a day full of love and embracing the people closest to us. But on this day in 2018, the only thing flying through the air were bullets in Parkland, Florida. The events of this day would lead to the third deadliest school shooting in United States history, following Virginia Tech and Sandy Hook. After the events of this day, the hunger for safer schools has never been stronger. Parents, students, and teachers alike are desperate for a change. However, everything in the world comes at a price, and schools nearby cannot afford to equip themselves with the newest technologies.
I think it would take a lot of budget to replace the current safety precautions we have. I think that's our number one barrier for sure. I'm part of our safety team committee that we have here, and everything that we've tried to suggest beyond what we're doing right now, most of the time when we're told we can't do something, it's a budget thing. That costs $30,000. This costs this much money. It's like beyond our hands.
Many people have let out cries for help, begging for schools to become safer. Policies that have always been in code of conduct started to become more enforced after Valentine's Day. But some are skeptical and do not believe these regulations are doing much, if anything at all.
The new policies are we have to wear our IDs when we get in the school, and we all have one entrance in the mornings when before we had like three or four.
In the hallways, it seems that most of them just put their their IDs in their backpacks and walking around. I don't see them.
I was never a believer in the whole wearing an IDs thing because I knew from the very beginning that's all it was. It was all just a false sense of security. It was all just something that the school board did to be like, oh, this is what we're doing now, because now that all this has happened, we need to do something. I feel like it was just like a people pleaser.
When things are calm, it is human nature to become complacent. Once complacency settles into schools, no one minds the safety precautions like wearing an identification badge or coming through a single point of entry as seriously as when first enforced. The schools are trying to find ways to get all students to abide by the policies. But with defiance being a common factor, this could be more difficult than expected.
So we need to think of ways, and the school is, trying to think of ways of how can we make it an incentive for the students to wear the IDs, that it's not a punishment if you don't have it, but you know, you can't get into the media center without it. Or maybe, you know, you need, in order to buy a prom ticket, you need to show your ID to get into prom, have your ID.
I just believe, unfortunately, both at this age and in the sort of society we're in, if you don't offer people something for doing something or don't force them to do it, they're not going to do it.
There is always a talk about how students are the number one priority. This statement could not be true because the step to extreme safety in schools has not been implemented. And it all comes down to the money being spent in the wrong areas.
They passed state laws that are supposed to make this safety a rule now. Of course, they didn't give us a budget to make those laws take effect. They just passed laws that said we had to do it. We're trying to do the best we can within the budget we're given. I think there's a lot more that can be done if the state and the county would give us the money to do it. I'm sad to say that a lot comes down to money, but unfortunately it does.
They haven't put bulletproof windows in the doors because of budget, but they remodeled the gym and they gave us new bleachers for the football field. When we don't even have football games, I think they should take our safety into way more consideration, given the fact that the school system preaches how the youth is the future. If we're the future, shouldn't you care a little more about us?
Broward Teen News was brought to you by ProSound and Video.